Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Clifford Pink Flamingo Power Wash. I'm back with a brand new video for you guys. Today we're going to be doing a little more fabrication on the new Isuzu NPR pressure washing truck. We're going to be building the bottom area with a door so I can have extra storage space for paper sealers, buckets, sand, and all that. My man Jamie's back today, same guy that did my ladder rack. If you haven't seen the video, make sure you go ahead and check it out. We're also going to be bracing my IBC totes so they don't move, rather than you know, putting holes in the bed. You know, you could use eye bolts, you could use those D-rings and all that, but I feel like, you know, those things, I don't want them to be moving around, and I got two of them, so that's a lot of water when I have to carry that. Most of the time I'm only going to be using one IBC tote. I'm not going to be using both unless I have like a commercial job, but they're going to be in a cage and secure so they never have to move. And I really didn't want to put more holes in the bed, man, because with SH, if you have a spill, I don't want that to go through the holes and, you know, corrode the wires and fall underneath and affect the frame of the truck. So you guys going to see Jamie doing his thing like last time. It's going to be a nice little project, so let's go see what the layout is. So like I said, Jamie's back. Y'all already know, dynamic mobile welding. So the plan is we're going to, let me go around this way kind of loud. So the plan is to put a brace going this way. We're going to put one going that way, all the way around, boxing the IBC totes in. I am going to run them this way instead of the side by side, so I can put the weight more distributed in the middle of the bed. So, you know, I'm not too heavy in the front. So underneath, we're gonna box that in, put a floor down there, and put a door on each side. We're gonna do a door on each side so we can have access to remove, you know, sealers, sand, maybe put a toolbox down there, miscellaneous stuff like that. I am gonna have a surface cleaner rack made by Jamie Alls as well, but I'm not sure if we have enough material to do it today, so we'll be doing it next time. So under here, this is where we're gonna, this is where we're gonna put the floor here. I gotta be, tell them to be careful, cause I see some wiring down here for like trailers and harnesses and stuff like that. So we gotta figure out something about that. But yeah, so this is the project for the day. You guys stay tuned, enjoy the video, man. Right.
You know what I mean?
All right, guys, so Jamie's plugging along. These guys are fast, man. So we're gonna put a door here. We got the hinges. The door is gonna open. I got my leash on, 'cause I was walking my dog. Sorry. But we're gonna open the door all the way. So it's gonna open all the way, so it's not gonna stick out. You know what I'm saying? So when you open the door from there, it's gonna open, and then it's gonna stick out in the back. All right? We're cutting the doors right now, and then they're gonna install that next.
All right, you guys, we're making good progress. We just got the doors installed, at least one of them. We're gonna do the other side. Jamie's gonna fabricate my surface cleaning rack. We don't have enough material to do the bracing around the IBC tote, so therefore, we're gonna have to just come back and do it later. We need one more stick of 2-inch aluminum. We thought we was gonna have enough, but we didn't. So we're gonna use some of that just to make the surface cleaner rack. The doors will be done. Well, next thing to do would be plumbing, man. So these guys are working real hard. I appreciate, you know, the efforts. Gonna get me right and rolling soon. And I'm gonna be getting the cab wrapped, as well as get the signage up top. I already got an estimate for that also. So I'm gonna let them make all that noise and watch. All right, guys, we're making progress. Jamie's up there doing the ladder stoppers so the ladders don't slide. Shout out to my boy Don. He gave me the idea. Well, made a notice of it last time the ladder rack was built, that I didn't have those. It's just an extra layer of protection when you slide a ladder so they don't, you know what I'm saying, slide off. Look like these boys are wrapping up. Almost done. They're almost done. He just got to finish up the surface cleaner rack and we'll be done, right? All right, so we're going to go ahead and get this surface cleaner rack set up. I'm not going to bolt it down today.
So I want to figure out where I'm gonna actually put it. A lot of times you have these pins on here where you can take both apart, like the bottom part and the handle. I had him weld this last time he was here, so this is one solid piece. What happens is inside of here, the weld breaks off where the seam is, and the handle starts flopping around. You can see I have some bolts in here, some screws that I had put in, but it was still like shaking a lot. So now it's all one solid piece. I'm gonna go ahead and probably put it on this side of the truck. All the equipment is gonna be on the other side. The gas tank is gonna go here. So yeah, we're making good progress, man. You guys, we all finished for the day. I gotta get going because I got a job I have to actually do. This took a little longer than expected because, you know, fabrication works takes time. Nothing is scripted, nothing, so everything is custom. So let me show you guys what the doors look like. This is the driver's side. Look it in there. Hello. Plenty of room, man. Look like a Puff Daddy 1990 music video in here. So yeah, this is this side here. I gotta get the locks for it. I did put the ladder stoppers up top, so that's up there. This is the other door over here on this side. Looking good, plenty of storage. I can see my connections for my lights. This has a trailer hitch harness also. So I got that going. Next time we're gonna be doing the bracing for the tanks. So nothing moves. So that's it for the day, guys. I gotta get going. It's gonna probably rain at 5 o'clock right now. It's 2 o'clock. So I got 2 hours to do this job. These guys did a fantastic job again. You see it. I ain't catch your name, bro. What's your name again?
Carlos?
Ricardo. And Ricardo is helper to Jamie. Y'all know Jamie already. Uh-huh. This man's a beast too, man. These boys out here been working since like 9 o'clock nonstop, man. They figure out a way to get everything done. So y'all give him a call if y'all need anything custom. My man travel anywhere if the money's right.
Best welders out here in Tampa.
There you go, the best ones, man. And they come to you, man. You ain't gotta go to no shop. You ain't gotta go to no shop, man. They pull up to where you at, get the job done. So y'all enjoy the video, man. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Stay tuned for the next one. I'm gonna catch y'all. Peace.